that we must continue to suffer to the end. We must continue taking our virtue to sin out of our hearts. And we must continue to work with the effort of the purgatory we see that we need to discern. We need to give. We need to embrace. There are a number of elements that we need to discern and embrace and experience over this year. Because you see, the old scorecard was all about bodies and bodies and buildings. But the new scorecard for the church of the Lord Jesus Christ in 2015 is deserving, engaging, and important. And so we have been discerning, if we have a missionary mentality or not, to go and take it a step further, and we need to embrace vital. From place to place, about First of all, in verses 1 through 16, it says, "By grace believers are workers. For the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man that is at house labor, which went out early in the morning to hire labor into his vineyard. And when he had agreed with the laborer for a penny a day, he sent them into his vineyard. And he put a worker to work for what they agreed to work for." A worker to work for what we agreed to work for. And when I talk about the third hour, so I have a dead cow on the marketplace and says to them, "Go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right, I will give you," and they will go away.
Is it not lawful for me to do what I will with my Lord? If I might, you will, because I am willing.
the last will be first, and the first last, and for many be called, but few chosen. Now, we're not going to talk about the theological implications of this text, but today we're just going to make it really practical. That way, you don't have to do that. Make them want to study that. And the practicality of this verse is simply this. A Bible degree is a work. Now, with that, verses 17 to 19, Jesus tells us that Bible readers are developed. And Jesus joined up the group from took the 12 disciples apart in the way and said to them, "Behold, we go up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man shall be betrayed unto the chief priests and the scribes, and they shall condemn him to death, and shall deliver him to the Gentiles to mock and the scourge and to crucify him, and the third day he shall rise again." I want to know if you can say that Bible readers are developed. But what did Jesus do with these 12 disciples? He took them apart. That seems to take them apart like we take them apart. We pull them apart, we make them apart. Don't you think Jesus took them aside, took them away, to give them a seminar, a little conference, a little one-on-one? He was going to train them, he was going to develop them. Many times we say, I'm not a born leader. There are no born leaders. Leaders are always the best. And we can be good leaders, we can be bad leaders, we can be vibrant leaders, and we can be vibrant leaders. But we're all leaders. And we need to develop ourselves so that we can be better leaders and vibrant leaders. That we can see our families and lead our homes and lead our churches and lead our communities and lead our world. We need to develop ourselves. We do that through the Word of God. We do that through education. We do that by going back to school. We do that by learning a trade. We do that in the digital ministry. We do that by being around other vibrant leaders and successful people. Let me tell you something. If you want to become a millionaire, don't hang around somebody.
Thank you.
been told all my life, as you say, Elizabeth, it doesn't matter. I have to listen. But today, as you make a living, thank you, Jesus. That's really what the denomination is all about. People are out of the denomination of the family. It's a couple of hours to start this thing. But what the thing is, we're not going to take a stand on the baptism. But if you're baptism today, you can come and join this church. And so, we would never join the Methodist church. We would never join the Catholic church. We would never join the Presbyterian church. We would never fight for a Catholic church. We would never join the Catholic church. We would never join the Catholic church. We would never join the Catholic church. That's not the point. Thank you. behold, you know, your Bible doing? Somebody's going to find you. And behold, two young men stood by the wayside when they heard that Jesus passed by, cried out, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, thou Son of David." And my people rebuked them because they should hold their peace. Thank you. vibrant leadership is that? Number four, vibrant leadership brings people to worship, live, and do first couple of them on the mission of transforming the world to the gospel. The mission of God was their priority. It's involved in making sure that the church is just in the mission of God, not for their mission, not what they think the church is supposed to be, but what God believes and wants the church to be. 2,000 years ago, Jesus didn't say to these vibrant leaders, run after dreams. My purpose for you is a warm and fuzzy brand new view. No, Jesus said, you're going to have problems and troubles, but you need to be vibrant leaders of this world. And I send you on a mission. I give you my peace. I give you my spirit. I give you my command. I give you my mission. Now go. Preach the vision to the sin. Thank you. Thank you.